been in Miami for a few years now, getting into the real estate business. But now I'm back here in New York, and I have a lot of things to straighten out.
It's an iconic, you know, epic, monumental milestone for the franchise, right? This is the little show that could, just like they counted hip hop out and didn't think that it was here to stay. Love and Hip Hop is here to stay. 10 seasons in is something to be incredibly proud of. And to have all of the cast members who started with us recognize that by coming home, it's gonna be epic.
Suddenly, reality TV has entered into the race for the presidency. I mean, it's like some Love and Hip Hop stuff.
We've become a part of the fabric, a part of their lives, a part of their conversations, a part of their vernacular. President Obama shouting us out, you know, we mean something. And when something resonates in that way, it's not going anywhere. What comes to mind is that staying power of the culture, of the hip hop culture, right? The ability to give people, the audiences, some opportunity to see themselves reflected on a show in a way that didn't at the time and still doesn't in this very same way exist for them. Here we have, you know, our women who look beautiful every single time they get in front of that camera. Stories that are being told in this compelling way with a narrative that for a lot of people, they couldn't even begin to imagine the lives that they live and the loves that they experience. So my expectation is that those stories are going to continue to exist. And as long as we have the platform and the opportunity to keep telling them, we should. Of course, it's gotten difficult when the backlash kicks in, when people want to say things, but I'm proud of this franchise. I'm proud of being on our 10th season of New York, right? How many people can say that? I'm proud of the numbers that we pull. That's just New York. That speaks to something. We are touching people. We're impacting people.